Hey guys, how are you all? My name is Harshit Divedi and I welcome you to my video. So in this video, friends, I will be talking to you regarding the debris which is created by the Mission Shakti test of India's anti-space weapon satellite. So what has happened, friends, that recently India conducted ASAT test, and through this Mission Shakti, it destroyed a Microsat R that was a DRDO satellite, friends. Okay, so it was non-functional, so obviously India destroyed it in low Earth orbit at a height of around 277 to 283 kilometers above the Earth's surface. Now, what has happened, friends, that the global community has not very openly criticized India, but recently what happened, the National Aeronautics and Space Administration, NASA Administration, Jim Bridenstine, he said that shooting down of its own satellites has created 400 pieces of orbital debris, and this action of India is condemnable. This was the statement of NASA's administration, NASA's chief. NASA chief has said that now the risk of debris colliding with this International Space Station of India has increased by 44% in the last 10 days. Now, what is happening, friends? India has done this test only 5 to 6 days ago, and these type of statements are coming from the NASA head. And NASA head is clearly saying that yes, risk to International Space Station has increased. Okay, now first of all, you should know what is this International Space Station. International Space Station is a habitable artificial satellite. It flies at an altitude of around 330 to 435 kilometers in between that. And it circles the Earth in around 92 minutes, complete Earth. And, you know, carries on 15.5 orbits. That is, every day it goes on around the Earth completely 15.5 times. This ISS, International Space Program, this International Space Satellite is actually a joint venture of United States NASA, Russia's Roscosmos, Japan's JAXA, ESA, that is European Space Agency, Europe, and CSA, Canada. Okay, now see, friends, there has been some stats given by European Space Agency. We are trying to decipher whether India's satellite test is actually dangerous from the perspective of international space satellites and other satellites. We are going to look at here. We are going to compare the stats that will make these things very much clearer to you. What happened, friends, that European Space Agency in its report had said that there are 34,000 objects of 10 centimeters or above in space, around 90,000 objects of sizes between 1 and 20 centimeters, and around 128 million sizes between 1 mm and 10 mm. This is a report given by European Space Agency. So this much amount of debris is going on in the space. As far as the India's anti-satellite test is concerned, the NASA chief has said that there are at least 400 pieces from the wreck. They were tracking 60 of them, which are more than 10 centimeter in size, and it is said that 24 of these 60 pieces may pose a potential threat to International Space Satellite. And how much is the threat potential? This has not been detailed by NASA. Though this is basically a statistical figure given by the European Space Agency. This is said that till now 5,450 successful rocket launches in space has been done since the space age has begun. Then 8,950 satellites has been placed in Earth orbits. 5,000 of these satellites are still in space, and 1,950 satellites are still functional, friends. 500 breakups have occurred till now, which has led to the fragmentation of small debris, and that debris is floating in the space. And it is said that 22,300 debris objects are regularly tracked by space surveillance networks. And the technology of tracking this space debris is present with NASA and European Space Agency. Indian Space Research Organization doesn't have this capability to track the space debris. So as far as whenever India does a launches of its satellite, as far as knowing the location of the space debris is concerned, India contacts NASA or European Space Agency, because India itself doesn't have the power to track the space debris, because that much technology ISRO at this point of time is not having. Okay, now let us have a look at what was the scenario before this happened. What happened, friends? This 3524 pieces of China were there, 4025 4091 80. Before this happened, friends, before this ASAT satellite explosion was carried on by India, India had 80 pieces of debris tracked. That means India's debris, when compared to the debris of other countries, is very, very low. You can see that 4,091 debris pieces are being done by USA, and 4,025 by Russia, and 3,524 by China. And then compared, India is having very small amount of debris. This was pre-ASAT scenario. Okay, now I'm going to tell you some more important facts about this thing. Just keep in mind, friends. We are going to analyze that how much risky this debris is, especially the Indian debris. And we are going to talk it from the perspective of International Space Satellite. See, friends, International Space Satellite, okay, this is very important initiative. I have told you this is initiative of, you know, European agencies, combined initiative. Now, what happens, friends, that the trajectory of International Space Satellites, which is flying at a height of around 400 kilometers from the Earth's surface, its trajectory is actually scanned 3 times a day. And the satellites are specially tracking all the time that whether this ISS is not heading in the space of a, you can say, debris. So there is a space box of 25 kilometer by 25 kilometer by 4 kilometer. Okay, so 4 kilometer height, okay, and 25 by 25 length breadth. So in this box of the International Space Station, if any debris is scheduled to come in between, then it is considered to be a potential threat, and therefore one system has been manufactured. That system is Debris Avoidance Maneuver, DAM, Debris Avoidance Maneuver. So when the International Space Satellite is seen to go on a collision course of debris in this 25 by 25 by 4 kilometer space box, obviously this Debris Avoidance Maneuver comes into play, and the trajectory of this International Space Station is changed. Until now, you can say that around 25 times this debris avoidance maneuvers have taken place. It started in 1999 and the last one was in 2015, friends. Okay, now coming on to the Indian satellite, friends. The 24 additional pieces, they pose a risk to ISS. However, it has not been told that how much risk are they posing and what is the actual amount of risk that these 24 debris which has been caused due to Indian anti-satellite test are going on a collision course with ISS. This is still not clear. Okay, friends. Yes, it has been said that they are posing a threat. How much threat they are posing, this has not been told by anyone. What is the stance of India on this thing? India is saying that India has conducted a test at around 283 kilometers height above the Earth's surface. Okay, International Space Station is flowing at around 400 kilometers above the Earth's surface. Okay, now India said that when this anti-satellite explosion will be done by India, what will happen that at the height of around 300 kilometers, atmospheric drag is still there. And obviously those debris is going to suffer the atmospheric drag. They will come into the Earth's atmosphere and they will burn because of air friction. So this was the official stance of India. But what happens, friends, when this hit occurred, lot of fragment, they flied off in various directions. Okay. And it is being said by NASA that many of those fragments, especially 24 of those fragments, may threaten the International Space Stations. However, our scientist, the ISRO scientist, is saying that we have done the explosion at a height of 283 kilometers. Just have a look at it. Okay. 283 kilometers. The International Space Station, or you can say satellite, is flowing at a height of 400 kilometers. So there is a huge difference in between. In any case, if the debris has gone towards the International Space Satellite collision course, then also the maximum kilometers that debris can go is 50 kilometers. This is the official stance of ISRO. Okay. So it is a very less chance that these, you know, space debris is going to hit the International Space Station in any time in future. And even if this is going to happen, that DAM technique is going to avoid it, friends. Okay. Now the problem is ISRO cannot have an official stance on it, because Indian Space Research Organization does not have the resource or capability to track space debris. When comes the capability to track space debris, NASA has command over it and European Space Agency has command over it, because they have a network of radars, they have optical instruments across the globe through which they can track the space debris. But India cannot track the space debris. That is why India is not able to give a very scientific stance in this thing, friends. Okay, and when we are going to compare our test with the test of other countries. So other countries' test has been very dangerous. You can see the debris in orbit by China, Russia and US. They are very, very huge, especially the anti-satellite test, which was carried out by China. You know, the Penguin 1C spacecraft in 2007, it created 1.5 lakh pieces. And of those, 3,428 pieces are being tracked through radar, friends. Okay, so this is the case. Okay, friends. Now, one thing that is more important we should need to know, friends, is that what is actually the danger of these small pieces, friends? I have already told you that, you know, a lot of different types pieces are traveling. See, for example, in this figure, you can see the debris is something like this. 34,000 greater than 10 centimeter pieces, 9 lakh 1 to 10 centimeter pieces, to 128 million 1 to 10 mm pieces. Okay, friends. Now, what happened, friends? At a height of around 300 kilometers, you know, much near to where India has carried on this test. What happens there? That there the objects are moving at a very high speed. The speed is 8 meters per second, which transforms to 28,000 kilometers per hour. So the debris is traveling, many debris is traveling at a speed of 28,000 kilometers per hour to stay in their orbits. And friends, if there is a small debris of 100 grams and if it is traveling at that speed, if it impacts, for example, a piece of 100 grams at this speed of 28,000 kilometers per hour hits the International Space Station, it is going to create an impact which will be equivalent to if a 30 kg stone hits a thing at a speed of 100 kilometers per hour. Okay, friends. So if a 30 kg stone, you can very well assume how heavy will be a 30 kg stone. So if a 30 kg stone at a speed of 100 km per hour hits a thing, that will be the same force if a 100 gram thing is hitting a satellite at the speed of 28,000 km per hour, and this much amount of space can destroy the satellite. And if it is not destroying, it will make the satellite dysfunctional. So not only the International Space Station, through the space debris, almost all of the satellites are in danger. Because once what happened, that a US and Russia satellite, they collided with each other. Okay. The radar was not there and they both collided with each other. And that was one unfortunate incident. However, that type of incidents has not happened till now. This Russian satellite was Cosmos 2251 and the US satellite was Iridium 33. So basically, the Cosmos Russian satellite was actually inactive. And the US satellite, which collided with it, was a operational communication satellite, and this collision happened in low Earth orbit. Because of that, because at that point of time, you can say, friends, in 2009, not proper tracking was being done and it collided, unfortunately. Okay, so obviously, now see, one more point to look at here is that space is very vast. Okay, so a lot of space debris are going, but still, despite these two, that is the Russian satellite and the US satellite, they collision. Not many other cases of collision with the satellites are there. The reason for this is that space is very huge and debris according to that space is very less. But yes, definitely that debris causes a threat, because if the dam, you know, capability of International Space Station was not there, then obviously International Space Station collision was bound to happen. That is why 25 times dam has been done and the trajectory of International Space Station has been changed till now. So the hue and cry against India, you know, NASA's chief is criticizing India. Pakistan is expressing his concern against India. Pakistan has a habit of expressing concern in everything against India. So it is obviously that, yes, some amount of debris has formed. But yes, that amount of debris is way, way lower than the debris caused by other countries. Okay, friends. So it should not be blown out of proportion. What needs to be done here is that an international treaty with respect to space power should be signed, in which this orbital debris issue should be detailed with the whole global standing, with the whole global meeting, so that a proper consonance can be brought in, because every individual country is planning to have this capability. Till now, four have this capability: US, Russia, China, and now India. So thank you for watching this video, friends. I hope this video has given us some amount of knowledge to you. So thank you for watching, friends. Have a great day. Keep studying.